Guys, this is Melody Abong, and today we will gonna talk about the Vicente Silva Manansala's painting. But before that, we will get to know him first. So, Vicente Silva Manansala was born on January 22, 1910 at Makabebe, Pampanga. From 1926 to 1930, he studied at the University of the Philippines School of Fine Arts. And in 1949, Manansala received a six-month grant by UNESCO to study at the École des Beaux-Arts Arts in Banff and Montreal, Quebec, Canada. So in 1950, he again received a nine-month scholarship to study at the École des Beaux-Arts Arts in Paris by French government. So Vicente Manansala is known as Mang Enteng, posthumously declared as a national artist upon his death in 1981. He was a remarkable artist and human being of larger than life proportion. A newsboy, golf caddy, and a bootblack in his youth, and the son of Makabebe, base barber carried the tough street language and garrulous demeanor of his roughneck childhood in pre-war Intramuros, well, into his sunset years in the 70s. When he was one of the most financially successful artists of his generation, he schooled in the starch-neck ways of the old Arroyo Public School and the University of the Philippines, as I have mentioned earlier, of fine arts. Enteng could also be charming and famously gallant to women. Although in his early adulthood, he was somewhat of a torpe that it took him 8 years of on and off courtship to persuade her former Himinigelda Diaz to be his wife. Eloping with her after planting their first kiss during a movie date. So to show to you his face, so I printed his face from Google, of course. I researched it. So this is Vicente Silva Manansala. And Manansala paintings are the best and were celebrated as the best of the barrio and the city together. So his Madonna of the Slums, this art by him, which is our main topic for today, is a portrayal of a mother and a child from the countryside who became urban chanty residents once in the city. So in his jeepneys, which is also his work called jeepneys, Manansala combines the elements of provincial folk culture and the congestion issues of the city. So most of his work is a combination of culture and issues here in the Philippines. That's why he is so influential by his work, by his art and paintings. So, Manansala developed the transparent cubism, wherein the delicate tones, shapes, and patterns of figure and environment are masterfully superimposed. So a fine example of Manansala using this transparent and translucent technique in his composition called Kalabaw. You must check it also. So that was also his best masterpiece. Vicente Manansala is a national artist of the Philippines in visual arts and was a direct influence to his Filipino neorealist like Malalang, Angelito Antonio, Norma Beliza, and Manuel Baltimore. So, in the Honolulu Museum of Art, the Lopez Memorial Museum, the Philippine Center, the Singapore Art Museum, and Holy Angel University, which is on Angeles City, Philippines, here only in the Philippines, are among the public collections holding work by Vicente Manansala. So, recently, Holy Angel University opened a section of its museum called the Vicente Manansala Collection, holding the most of the estate self left by Manansala. Okay. So this is his work, The Madonna of the Slums, which is also they said this is Cubist style. So the painting is originally 86.5 by 61 centimeter, and it is considered the key modernist in 1950s. So the painting now is belong to the National Museum collections, and the Madonna of the Slums is said to be the portrayal of a mother and child from the countryside who became urban shanty residents once in the city. So so this image were tightly focused on the two subjects. That's what you can see in the image, the mother and the child. So as what you can see, the mother is hugging on her child and with her two hands, and as well as the child is holding her mother's face. So there are also background, which are the houses, and the color composes of brown and the a little bit dark here. So the painting is not about happiness, obviously, but more on sadness, as they interpret this. Many interpreted this painting as poverty during that time. So I do believe that the real picture has its deep meaning. So we must also access his painting and get to know about it. Many said that his painting really portrayed the life before, during post-war. As far as we know that our country is colonized by many colonizers out from our country, diba? So this painting really portrayed the sadness, the reality. They say that reality sucks. Many of women and children were actually suffering from poverty during the post-war. So that's why Vicente Manansala portrayed this painting. As what you have noticed, the child has no dress at all, and the detail really portrays the culture before, the situation before. You can really say that poverty before is really that of use, because from this painting palang, you can see that the mother and the child is not that so well, and the background is also portrays the reality upon this painting. So guys, that's all for today, and I hope you will also visit websites which contains Vicente Manansala's paintings, wherein most of his works were very influential, and eye-opener to those who didn't know the situation before, after the post-war. I mean, after the war. So, that's all for today, and thank you for watching.
Lily was a little girl, afraid of the big white world. She grew up within her castle walls. Now and then she tried to run, and then on a night with the setting sun, she went in the woods away, so afraid, all alone. They warned her, don't go there. There's creatures who are hiding in the dark, and something came.